The presentations are based on four presentations that will be held over the next 3 days. And ultimately, we are fortunate to be able to have Dr. Dragan Ivanov here. He is here from the college in Novi Sad in Serbia, and he is a specialist for internal medicine. And as you can see from the topics here, we're going to be covering some really interesting and important topics throughout this weekend. And today, the topic is, how can you improve your brain function? So with that, I would like to again thank you for your patience in waiting for the beginning, and I would like to call forth Dr. Dragan Ivanov and Walter Lukic, who will be translating.
Dobro večer svima.
Good evening to all.
Drago mi je da se nalazim večeras zajedno sa vama ovde.
I'm very pleased to be with you this evening.
Pre nedelju dana bio sam u Vancouveru.
A week ago I was in Vancouver.
I tamo smo imali također predavanje na slične teme.
And there we also had a lecture, series of lectures on similar topics.
I meni je zadovoljstvo da sa vama podelim određene informacije.
And it's my pleasure to share with you some valuable information.
I to informacije koje se tiču jednog veoma značajnog aspekta našeg života.
And that information that are related to a very important aspect of our life.
Mi smo u naslovu predavanja stavili jedan zadatak.
In the title of this lecture we put before us a task.
Treba da odgovorimo na pitanje kako da poboljšamo rad našeg mozga.
So we are looking for an answer to the question, how can we improve the work of our brain?
Ja ne želim da kažem da vaš mozak ne radi kako treba, ne radi dobro.
I'm not going to say that your brain doesn't work properly.
Ali sam hoću da kažem.
But what I would like to say.
Hoću da ovim predavanjem ukažem na to, šta mi sa svoje strane možemo učiniti.
With this lecture I want to point out to what we can do to improve the function of our brain.
I evo vidjet ćemo da neke korake možemo uraditi i da na taj način poboljšamo mentalne funkcije.
So I would like to show to you that we can make for certain steps and that they can lead to significant improvement.
Mozgovi vladaju svijetom.
So brains rule the world.
Mozak upravlja državama, kompanijama, bankama, sportskim klubovima.
So the brains govern states, governments, companies, corporations, different clubs, organizations.
Mozak na kraju krajeva upravlja porodicom i celim našim
organizacijama. So brain ultimately rules or governs our families and the entire society, human society.
Mozak je ne samo onaj, mozak je ne samo gospodar i vladar.
Brain is not just the ruler and the commander.
Yeah. Mozak je i izvor onog svih naših emocija.
So brain is also the source of all our emotions.
Mozak je organ iz koga izviru najlepša naša osjećanja, osjećanja poput ljubavi.
And the brain is actually the source from which spring our most precious feelings and emotions. Love, for example.
Deficit znanja u mozgu.
So a deficit of knowledge, lack of knowledge in the brain.
Može da predstavlja ili predstavlja jednu ozbiljnu opasnost za celokupno naše biće.
Can present or pose a serious threat for our entire being.
Ono što je bitno da znamo,
what is important to know,
je to da zdrav mozak on omogućava nam da sve njegove funkcije rade bolje i kvalitetno.
So healthy brain enables or promotes all other functions of the body. So a healthy brain enables you to include these mental and emotional abilities in your life, while a damaged and unstable brain significantly impedes that process.
Svako od nas želi da vodi jedan uspešan i radosan život.
Everyone or each one of us would like to have a successful and pleasant life.
Svi mi hoćemo da nešto promenimo i poboljšamo naše život.
We all like to improve in some ways our lives.
Ali ako želimo da ulepšamo i poboljšamo naš život,
but if we really would like to make significant improvement in our life,
tada treba da znate odakle treba početi.
Then you should know where you should start.
Treba početi tu promenu, treba početi od našeg mozga.
So the change, this improvement should start with our brain.
Kad promenimo naš mozak,
when we change the brain,
promenit će se i ulepšati naš život.
Then our life will be changed and made more pleasant.
I ajde da vidimo, odnosno da govorimo na pitanje kako da poboljšamo naše moždane.
So let's try to answer the question how we can improve the brain function.
Ono što je važno na početku,
in the beginning I'd like to emphasize,
jeste informacija,
it's information,
da naš mozak može bolje da radi.
Our brain could work better. So our brain can function better, genes are not destiny, and none of us is permanently defined by our ancestors and birth. Our destiny is not necessarily predetermined by the hands of those who shaped us in the first few years of our life. We do not have to be permanent victims of our past bad choices and actions.
Ovo je jedna ohrabrujuća činjenica.
This is a very encouraging fact.
Do prvih 15 godina,
about 15 years ago,
mislilo se da oštećen mozak ne može više da se regeneriše.
It was thought that a damaged brain cannot be repaired or regenerated.
Da izumrle ćelije mozga ne mogu da se obnove i da se stvore nove ćelije.
That the dead brain cells cannot be restored.
Ali zahvaljujući funkcionalnom ispitivanju sa magnetnom rezonancom,
but thanks to the examinations being done with magnetic resonance,
dokazano je da se mozak, da se moždane ćelije mogu regenerisati.
It has been demonstrated that the brain cells can be restored or repaired.
I samim tim naš mozak se može podići na viši nivo nego na kome se sada nalazi.
And in that way our brain can be elevated and brought to the higher level function.
Ja ću ovo predavanje sastoji se iz dva dela.
This lecture consists of two parts.
U jednom delu govorit ćemo, upoznat ćemo toksine koji deluju negativno na naš mozak.
In the first part we will talk about the toxins that have a negative impact or effect on our brain.
I u ovom predavanju vidjet ćemo šta bi trebalo da činimo i šta je to što stimuliše rad našeg mozga.
And in this lecture also we will see what we can do, what stimulates, promotes the healthy function of the brain.
Najprije ćemo se upoznati s jednim savremenim toksinom.
Now I'd like to introduce you to the one modern toxin.
O čemu se radi?
What is it?
Pa ne radi se o marihuani.
We are not talking about marihuana.
Mada je ovo, da ne stavljamo na slajdu o marihuani.
Although on the slide you can see the sign.
Poznato je da marihuana ima određena negativna dejstva na naš mozak.
Now, it's well known that marihuana has certain negative impact or effects on the brain.
I to je dokazano.
And that's proven.
Mada činjenica je da mnogi koriste marihuanu.
It is also the fact that some people use marihuana.
Da li vi neko od vas koristi marihuanu?
Does someone here use marihuana?
Da li neko od vas daje vašoj deci marihuanu?
Does anyone of you give to your children marihuana?
Niko se ne javlja.
No, I don't see that anyone is raising hand.
Poznato je da marihuana pravi određene štete.
It is known that marijuana has some negative undesirable side effects.
Ali postoji jedan savremeni toksin.
But there is a modern toxin.
Koji mi koristimo.
Which we use.
I ono što je još opasnije.
And what is even more damaging or
dangerous. Mi taj toksin dajemo našoj deci i našoj omladini.
We give that toxin to our children, our youth.
I da nismo svesni koje neželjeno dejstvo on ima.
And that we are not even fully aware of what are undesirable side effects.
I vas interesuje o kom tom toksinu je reč.
Would you like to know which toxin we're talking about?
Ja ne znam da li neki, da li postoji neko ko je rezistentan i ko je ravnodušan prema tom toksinu.
I do not know, is there anyone here who is how to say resistant or who is not attracted to this toxin?
Pre jedno godinu i pol dana sam imao u ruci jednu knjigu.
About a year and a half ago, I had in my hands a book.
Koja se zove Focus.
That was titled Focus.
Pisao se Daniel Goleman.
And the author is Daniel Goleman.
I evo neki izvodi ili neki izvodi iz istraživanja koje je on zapisao u svojoj knjigi.
And let me share with you some excerpts from the book.
Toxin broj 1.
Toxin number 1. excessive use of computers and mobile phones occupy the mind.
Ekscesivna, pretjerana, nekontrolisana upotreba savremenih sredstava komunikacije.
So we are talking about excessive use of the modern systems of communication, digital, you know, media.
I najnovija istraživanja,
and the most recent research,
pokazala su,
shows preoccupation with computers, emails, Facebook, internet, text messages, and mobile phones poses a serious danger.
Čak su opasniji od upotrebe marihuane.
They may be even more dangerous than use of marijuana. Yes.
Šta je konsekvenca i posljedica svega toga?
So what is the consequence? What is the result of all of this? Dizziness, fatigue, decreased ability to concentrate, have reached staggering levels.
Naš mozak je danas bombardovan neprekidnim dotokom brojnih informacija.
So our brain is, in our modern times, sort of contemporary society, is bombarded by the flow of information.
O kojim informacijama se to najčešće radi?
So what kind of information we are talking about?
Obično su to čak informacije koje su nezdrave i nekorisne za naš život.
Often these are is this information that is not useful, that is even harmful for our daily life.
I ova slika postala nešto potpuno uobičajeno.
And this image can become an everyday experience.
Pad koncentracije.
That is a decrease of concentration,
premorenost mozga, fizička iscrpljenost.
So this is a dizziness, fatigue, the whole body's fatigue, mental fatigue,
nervoza, anxioznost,
anxiety, depression.
Sve to na neki način rezultat ili posljedica jednog nezdravog stila života.
This all is or can be the result of unhealthy lifestyle.
I možemo reći pre svega nekontrolisane upotrebe ovih sredstava.
And we can say uncontrolled use of these means of communication.
I vreme je za oporavak.
And so there is a time for renewal or for yes.
Naš mozak treba da se regeneriše.
So our brain needs to be refreshed, to be regenerated.
Zalihe energije, naše mentalne energije su potpuno potrošene.
So these reserves of mental and physical energy are exhausted.
Treba da se isključimo iz tog neprekidnog i opasnog dotoka informacije.
So we have to somehow exit, leave this constant flow of information.
I što treba da činimo i šta
se... What we should do?
Neki ljudi upale televizor.
Some people turn on the TV.
I šta rade?
And what do they do?
Listaju one kanale na televizoru.
That are flipping the channels, you know, going through the
channels. I tako pokušavaju da se opuste i da regenerišu mozak.
And in that way they are trying to relax and to, you know, kind of relax their brain.
Pokazano je.
It was shown.
Da surfovanje po internetu.
That surfing the internet.
Gledanje televizije.
Watching TV.
Ne odmara i ne osvežava preopterećeni mozak.
Does not rest, does not bring your relaxation to the brain that is overloaded.
Istovremeno,
at the same time,
šetnja gradom,
walking, strolling down the street,
gradskim ulicama,
down the city streets,
također ne donosi osveženje.
Does not, likewise, does not bring rest to our body and our mind.
Ako hoćemo da osvežimo naš mozak,
if you want to really experience refreshment and to relax,
da se odmorimo,
to rest,
da pustimo, da damo priliku mozgu da se regeneriše,
to give an opportunity to the brain to regenerate,
treba da odemo u prirodu.
We have to go to nature, into nature.
Boravak u prirodi,
spending time in nature,
i mir prirode,
and the tranquility of nature,
obnavljaju zamoreni mozak,
that regenerate the tired brain,
i osvežavaju ili regenerišu,
and refresh, and help us refocus.
Ova nekontrolisana i ekscesivna upotreba savremenih sistema komunikacije deluje toksično na još jednu sferu našeg života.
This uncontrolled use of digital media also affects another sphere of our life.
O kojoj sferi je reč?
What sphere we are talking about? Excessive use of internet, Facebook, mobile phone, and text messaging destroys communication and relationships.
Right.
How do you like this communication?
Baš lepo, ovaj.
Display, that's nice, right?
Baš imaju lepo odnose, tako?
Very nice relationships.
On njoj okrenuo leđa.
He turned his back to her.
Ona njemu, tako?
And she turned her back to him.
I šta?
And what did they do?
On drži laptop.
He's holding the laptop.
Ona opet drži mobilni telefon.
She has a mobile phone.
A mogli su nešto drugo da rade.
And they could do something else.
Da ne? Oni su neko da regnu.
What do you think?
Oni mogu ljuda zagrli.
They could have rested on the bed and he could have hugged her.
Mogli su neko da pričaju.
They could have talked.
Šta se dešavalo toku dana?
What happened throughout the day?
Šta će raditi? Šta se dešavalo sa decom?
What happened to the children?
I tako u trenucima bliskosti u tonu usana.
And in that at that relaxed time of intimacy and closeness, they could have fallen asleep.
Kako se umnožavaju i povećavaju te elektronske mreže?
As we increase this network of electronic connections,
tako se razjedaju i kidaju emotivne veze među ljudima.
In the same degree or ratio, we are tearing down, destroying human relationships, that's human network.
Zapamtite.
Please remember this.
Uvećavanje i konektovanje tim decom, elektronskim vezama i tome slično, uništava i destruiše emotivne veze među ljudima.
The more we integrate, the more we connect through this media, digital media, the more connections we have through them, the fewer or connections we will have, quality connections with other people.
Činjenica je da mi ne možemo se potpuno rešiti ovih savremenih sredstava komunikacije.
The fact of life is that we cannot completely dispense with this modern gadget.
I da mi njih, ta sredstva komunikacije treba da koristimo.
We need to use them and we use them.
Ali zato je potrebno da poslušamo jedan savjet.
But therefore there is we have a need to listen to him one counsel. And it's here. Checking new messages is an important form of communication, but it is far better to set aside time during the day or week for that purpose and devote the rest of your time to what really matters.
To je dobar savjet.
That's a good advice.
Dok radimo, dok imamo neke obaveze.
While we are in the business hours, while we have some commitments.
Mi odvojimo jedno vreme, specijalno vreme za odgovaranje, za komunikaciju pomoću tih medija.
We set apart some time for checking these media, answering the messages.
I nakon toga to treba
izgledati. And after that, we should try and talk.
Kaže, treba da odvojimo vreme za ono što je najvažnije.
We have to make time or set apart time for that what is most important.
A šta je najvažnije?
And what is most important?
To su drugi ljudi.
These are other human beings.
Članovi naše porodice.
Members of our families.
Naš bračni drug.
Our spouses.
Naša deca, naši roditelji.
Children, our parents.
Ne zaboravimo.
Don't forget.
Da najviše radosti.
The most greatest joy.
Mi crpimo iz komunikacije.
We derive from our relationships with other human beings.
U slovenskom jeziku.
In the Slavic languages.
Sreća.
Reč sreća. Happiness or joy.
Izvire iz glagola sretati se.
Actually, the root meaning comes from the verb meeting.
Šta je sreća?
What does it mean? Happiness.
Kada se susretne.
Yes. When we meet.
Želja.
Desire.
Sa svojim ciljem.
When desire meets its object.
Kao rezultat, znači susreta to, javlja se sreća.
So, once that meeting takes place, our desire and the object of our desire, then happiness is the result, effect.
To ide iz same lingvistike, samih termina to izvira.
So in some languages, like in Slavic languages, this is actually coming from the root etymology, the root meaning of the word.
U engleskom to zvuči drugačije.
In English language it sounds a little bit different.
Ali ovaj u lepom slovenskom jeziku.
But in some Slavic languages it bases the meaning, the derivative meaning.
Reč sreća.
The word happiness.
Izvire iz susreta čovjeka sa svojim voljenim, sa drugim voljenim bićem. Voljeno biće, sretne drugo voljeno biće, i eto ti sreće.
Yes. So actually, when one human being that loves meets the other human beings that is loved, this meeting produces happiness or joy.
Znači, modern, frekventan toksin.
So modern toxin, modern age,
jeste koji oštećuje naš mozak,
which damages our brain,
koji vrši destrukciju naših socijalnih i emotivnih veza,
which has destructive effect on our social relationships,
zove se nekontrolisana upotreba,
it's called uncontrollable or uncontrolled use of digital media.
Okay. Idemo da vidimo sljedeću stvar.
Next thing.
Šta da činimo da naš mozak radi bolje?
So what should we do that to make our brain work better? That's the next part.
Osoba ima 23 godine.
So the person here has 23 years old.
I ovo je snimak mozga te osobe.
That's the image of that brain.
To je student.
It's a student.
Plava boja pokazuje pasivan, neaktivan mozak.
So the blue color on this scan shows the passive portion of the brain.
A negdje oko 20% mozga je samo aktivno.
And about 20% of the brain is active.
I aktivnost je u negdje u nekoj drugoj brzini rečeno onim.
Yeah, and that active part is kind of, you know, not really in the, it's in the second gear, it's on the side of the brain, not the main activity of the brain.
Znači radi, ali usporeno.
So the brain is active, but at a slow speed.
Najveći deo mozga je
the greatest part of the brain is
u jednom pasivnom kolapsnom stanju.
It's in a passive, languishing state of state. Now look at this image.
Ovaj mozak.
Look at this brain.
Kako lepše izgleda?
It looks much better.
Ovaj deo zeleno-crvena boja, to je aktivni deo mozga. Ova boja prikazuje.
That's right.
Da,
so this central part, the greenish part, it represents the active part of the brain.
Ova crvena boja prikazuje deo mozga koji veoma intenzivno radi.
And this reddish color represents the part of the brain that operates at the top maximum speed.
A jedan mali deo mozga je isključen iz funkcija.
And only smaller marginal part of the brain is not active here.
Šta je naša želja?
So what is our desire?
Da nam mozak bude ovakav.
That our brain should be like that on the left side or this on the right side?
I ovo je mozak osobe 23 godine, ovo je mozak osobe 23 godine.
And both brains are brains of a person, a 23-year-old person.
Zapamtite ovo. Ova osoba sedi i 4-5 sati uči.
So that person on the left side is actually sitting and studying for 4 or 5 hours.
Nakon 4 sata urađene, znači nakon 4 sata intenzivnog rada mozga u sljedećem stanju,
so after about 4 or 5 hours of active mental work studying, that imaging was done.
Potom je ta osoba nešto uradila.
Thereafter, the person did something.
Popila je na lek.
That person took a medication or pill.
Jedan doping sredstvo.
Yeah, this is kind of doping.
I nakon tog doping sredstva ovako izgleda mozak.
And after using that tablet or whatever medication, look how the brain looks like.
Ja ne znam da li u Kanadi je dozvoljeno i da li se koristi taj lek.
I don't know whether in Canada is permissible to use that medication or use remedy.
Ja mislim da nije skup.
I don't think it's expensive one.
Kako se zove?
How do we call it?
To treba da kažem, za ne?
Yeah, I should tell you that.
Šta da učinimo?
So, what should we do?
Da bi naš mozak
that our brain from that condition would transfer to this condition.
Fizička aktivnost.
Physical activity.
U trajanju od 45 minuta.
In about 40 minutes in duration, physical activity made a change, difference.
Dovele do prikazane promene.
Yes, the difference that you saw.
Postoji, koristili se taj lek.
So, do you know this remedy or medication here in Canada?
A fizička aktivnost,
physical activity,
koja dovodi do lakog zamora,
that brings to light sense of feeling tired.
Aktivnost koja dovodi do lakog, malo ubrzanog radnog srca I malo znojenja.
Yeah, the physical activity that increases the heart rate and some respiration.
Takva fizička aktivnost treba
naša. Such kind of physical activity is needed by our brain.
Ajde da vidimo efekte fizičke aktivnosti.
So let's see what are the effects of the physical activity. Physical activity increases the concentration of neurotrophic factors, production of brain hormones, and re-improves mental processes.
U svakoj zgradi postoji ovaj kako kaže ovaj housemaster.
Yeah. Yes, in every building, apartment building or larger building, there is a person who is taking care of maintenance person.
Ako se tamo na krovu pojavi neka rupa,
if there is on the roof, in the roof structure there is some hole or leak,
neko oštećenje na zgradi,
or damage in the structure of the building,
taj majstor to odmah popravi,
that maintenance person is quick to fix that.
Zašto?
Why?
Da ne bi ta šteta dovela do destrukcije I propadanja cijele zgrade.
To avoid or prevent that little damage cause much greater damage on the building.
U našem mozgu postoji takav jedan...
In our brain, there is such a handyman or maintenance person.
I taj, to je taj neutropic faktor.
And that is called neutrophic factor.
On popravlja oštećenja na našem mozgu.
He or that factor actually repairs the damages in our brain.
I zahvaljujući tome,
and thanks to that factor,
naš mozak može da se izleči ili da se oporavi nakon određenih oštećenja.
Our brain can be repaired or restored after some time.
I što više tog neurotropnog faktora imamo,
the more of this neurotropic factor we have,
I što je njegova koncentracija veća,
the greater its concentration,
naš mozak će,
our brain will,
bolje funkcionisati,
work better,
I sačuvati mladalačku svežinu I funkcionalnost,
and preserve or maintain its youthful form and function.
U toku fizičke aktivnosti dolazi do lučenja određenih moždanih hormona.
During physical activity, there are released certain hormones.
Jedan od tih hormona se zove, jedna grupa tih hormona zove se endorfini.
And one group of these hormones are called endorphins.
Ako bi sad mi dobili injekciju endorfina,
if you would receive an injection of endorphin right now,
šta bi se desilo?
What would happen to you?
Počeli bi se smejati.
We would start to laugh.
I to ne onako mirno I tiho.
Not quietly or low voice.
Nego bi se onako baš
pucali po sve. We would really, be laughing loudly.
Endorfini dovode do euforije.
So, endorphins bring to euphoria, status of euphoria.
Izaziva otrenja polove.
It removes the pain.
Podiže imunitet.
It elevates immunity.
Daje snagu, povećava snagu srcu I drugim našim mišićima.
It gives more power or strength to the heart and to muscles.
A koncentracija endorfina povećava se pod uticajem fizičke aktivnosti.
And the concentration of endorphins is increased when there is a physical activity.
Koja fizička aktivnost?
Which physical activity
je najbolja za naše telo I naš mozak?
Is best for our body and for our brain.
Teretana, dizanje teških tegova.
So, if you go to the gym, lifting the weights.
Ili trčanja.
Running.
Ili trčanje, plivanje.
Swimming.
Šta je bolje?
What is best? Now, look at this. Best physical exercises are aerobic exercises. That is, exercises that increase the heart rate.
Da. Aerobne vežbe su najbolje vežbe za naš mozak.
Aerobic exercises are the best exercises for the brain.
Ako hoćemo da imamo super mozak,
if you want to have a super brain,
treba da radimo dve stvari.
We have to do two things.
Malo jednu, malo drugu.
A little bit of one and another.
Šta treba da radimo?
What we need to do?
Treba da kombinujemo fizičke vežbe sa mentalnim naporom I mentalnim vežbama.
So we need to combine physical exercises with mental exercises or mental work.
Svaki organ koji radi, on se razvija I biva sve jače I jače.
Each organ of our body that is active increases, grows and increases in strength.
Ako jedan organ je pasivan I ne upotrebljava
ga, if any organ is passive, not in use,
taj organ atrofira I gubi svoje sposobnosti.
That organ will atrophy and lose its properties.
I zato veoma važan savez za naš mozak.
And very important advice for our brain.
Jeste, upotrebljavajte, koristite vaš mozak.
Brain as much as possible. Now, we have the third point here, use your brain or it will die.
Ako hoćemo da nam mozak bude aktivan I da bude živ I kvalitetan, upotrebljavajmo.
If we want to have the brain that is active and vibrant and healthy, we should use it.
Koja aktivnost razvija naše telesne mišiće?
Which kind of activity strengthens, develops our muscles, our body?
Dizanje biljuške, kašike.
Lifting the fork and spoon.
Kolače, ubacivanje kolača.
Put this in the mouth.
To neće raditi.
No, that is will not develop muscles.
Treba da uzemo određene tegove.
We need to take some weights.
I dizanje teških tegova.
And lifting these weights, heavier weights.
Uz napor.
Putting some effort.
To dovodi do razvoja mišića.
This promotes strength, muscle strength.
Isti princip važi za naš mozak.
Same principle applies for the brain. Now, your brain will grow and develop when you exert yourself beyond your habitual limits.
Naprežite vaš mozak.
So, exert your brain.
Neka se uhvati u koštac sa određenim problemima.
Let it come to grips with certain problems.
I onda će se on razvijati.
And then it will grow and develop.
Gledanje televizije.
Watching TV.
Gledanje filmova,
watching movies,
koji su, kažem, filmova koji predstavljaju ekranizaciju romana.
Yeah. Especially dramatized, you know, films and so on.
Je daleko, deluje destimulativno na mozak.
It has a destimulating effect on the brain.
Dok čitanje,
while reading,
deluje moćno I stimulativno na naš mozak.
Has a positive stimulating effect on the brain. Why?
Mi kad gledamo film,
when you watch a film,
šta naš mozak dobije?
What does your brain get?
Dobije na pasti sve.
On the plate, everything is served.
Mi vidimo kako glumac I kako glavni lik izgleda.
We see the main actor.
Mi vidimo kakva je kuća gde on živi.
We see the house in which
he lives.
How looks his garden or her garden.
A kad čitamo knjigu?
But when you read a book.
Šta se dešava?
But what happens?
Mi tamo vidimo neke znakove.
We are just seeing the signs on the page.
Koji se zovu slova,
which we call letters, characters.
I naš mozak od tih vizuelnih znakova.
And our brain scanning these visual signs.
I on od toga treba da uradi jedan važan posao.
The brain has to process that information.
On mora da napravi sliku, da stvori sliku u glavi, glavnog junaka.
The brain has to create an image of that main actor in our brain.
On mora da radi posao režisera I da napravi u svojoj glavi movie od onog tamo, od onih tamo nekih slova I rečenica.
So the brain has to do this work that the movie director does in the film, you know, it has to put these all elements together.
Zato svakog dana treba da čitamo.
This is why every day we should read.
Pola sata do sat vremena.
Half an hour, up to an hour.
Umesto da gledamo to vreme televiziju.
Instead of watching TV.
Uzmimo knjigu I čitamo.
Take a book and read.
Posebno.
Especially.
Pazimo na našu decu.
Especially. Let us watch our children.
Naša deca.
Our children.
Treba da mi, naše djece treba mi da čitamo I da ih postičemo da oni čitaju, umjesto da gledaju u ekrane I televiziju.
To younger children, we should, the parents should read, and when they're older, they should read themselves, instead of watching TV and watching the screens, the computer screens.
Kako stimulisati mozak?
How stimulate the brain?
Čitanjem.
By reading.
Umjesto gledanja televizije.
Instead of watching TV or internet.
Ima razne knjiga.
There are many books, different books.
Ima razne časopisa.
There are different magazines.
Laka literatura postiče površnost i ne deluje pogodno na naš mozak.
Superficial literature it stimulates superficiality of thinking and doesn't stimulate the brain.
Ako hoćete da čitate knjigu, ako hoćete da znate koja knjiga najbolja za stimulaciju mozga,
if you want to know which book is one of the best to stimulate the brain,
to je knjiga koju je čitao Newton.
This is the book that Isaac Newton read.
To je knjiga koju je čitao Einstein.
A book that Einstein read.
Koju knjigu čitao Nikola Tesla.
Nikola Tesla read a book.
To je knjiga koju vam poručujem.
And this is the book that I recommend to
you. Koja najbolje i najzdravije stimuliše mozak.
The best, the healthiest book to stimulate the brain.
To je zaboravljena knjiga.
Forgotten book often.
Koja se zove Biblija.
Which is called the Bible.
Ona stimuliše i levu i desnu hemisferu mozga.
That book stimulates both the left and the right side of the brain.
Ona tera naš mozak na algoritamsko razmišljanje.
That book stimulates or urges our brain to think in algorithmic way.
Okay, idemo dalje.
Let's go further.
Kako da stimulišemo naš mozak?
So how to stimulate the brain?
Radite uvek nešto novo.
Do something new. Always do something new. Yes. Avoid living on autopilot. Always learn something new. Use those parts of the brain that you normally do not use.
Ja, ovo je jako važno.
That is very important.
Sad tu imamo opasnost da vam pričam o levoj i desnoj hemisferi.
Now I could talk to
you. Da otrčim, da odem u priču o levoj.
Now I could talk to you about the left and the right hemisphere of the brain hemisphere.
Mi u našoj glavi, u našoj jednoj glavi imamo dva mozga.
So in our brain actually, in our head actually, we have two brains, so to say.
Jedan mozak je leva hemisfera, a drugi mozak je desna hemisfera.
One brain is the left hemisphere, the other is the right hemisphere.
Leva hemisfera je zadužena za prirodne nauke.
So left hemisphere is dedicated to the natural sciences.
Kao što je matematika, fizika, hemija.
Mathematics, physics, chemistry, biology.
Gramatika,
grammatic,
analitika, redovi, nizovi, pravila.
So rules, order, this is the left side of the brain.
I ona je vrlo precizna i dobro definisana.
And that left side is very precise, well structured, very precise.
S druge strane, desna hemisfera je malo, kako kažem, nekako potpuno drugačije.
On the other hand, the right hemisphere is somewhat different.
Tu se nalazi centar za imaginaciju, zapamtanje.
There is a center for imagination, for dreaming or daydreaming or
za umetnost,
for artistic work.
I da bi naš mozak bio izbalansiran,
and for our brain to be properly balanced,
potrebno je da hranimo i levu i desnu hemisferu.
It is important that we feed both right and the left side hemisphere of the brain.
Moramo znati, kako kažem, da bi preživjela leva, da bi preživjela leva ili desna hemisfera, ona mora dobiti određenu hranu, odnosno određeni stimulans.
So for either left or right hemisphere to function properly and to develop properly, it needs to be fed, to be stimulated by the other one.
Ako se neko bavi matematikom, fizikom, hemijom, elektronikom.
If someone of you is engaged in any activity like computer sciences or chemistry or biology, mathematics.
Tada njegova leva hemisfera intenzivno radi.
Then his or her left hemisphere is actively.
A desna je pasivna.
And the right one is more passive.
Šta kaže ovdje?
What does it say here?
Ako hoćemo da naš mozak se razvija,
if we want our brain to develop,
moramo nešto raditi.
We need to do something.
Moramo malo ostaviti tu levu hemisferu.
We now have to leave on this, aside the left hemisphere.
I raditi nešto što će aktivirati desnu hemisferu.
We have to activate the right hemisphere.
To znači
that means
da naučnici treba da malo odu u sferu umjetnosti, u sferu imaginacije, književnosti.
So which means, for example, some scientists should put aside the scientific work and maybe get engaged, get involved with some artistic work, with something that is creative, right?
I onda će se stvoriti uslovi da njihova leva hemisfera napreduje još više.
And that will create conditions, favorable conditions that the left hemisphere brain would even develop more.
Muzika aktivira I levu I desnu hemisferu.
Music stimulates both left and right side of the brain.
I zato predstavlja najbolje stimulativno sredstvo za naš mozak.
And this is one of the most or best stimulating means for our brain.
Ako hoćemo da vozimo od Hamiltona do Montreala, do Toronto ili Montreala.
If you want to drive, there are like wheels, line. That's right, the line. Then the car will pull one way or another.
Sporije ćemo stići do cilja.
We will arrive later. We will be slower.
Iskretat ćemo.
And we will constantly will be pulling. The car will be pulling one way or another.
Naš, ako je naš mozak izbalansiran.
If our brain is balanced.
Ako nam je dobro razvijena I leva I desna hemisfera.
If we have properly developed both hemispheres.
Bolje ćemo stići.
We will travel faster and we will arrive at our destination better.
Radite uvijek nešto novo.
So always do something new.
I šta još?
What else?
Use the parts of the brain that you normally do not use.
So use, yeah, you heard it.
Šta kaže jedna izreka?
What one proverb says, monotony deadens the brain. Monotony deadens the brain.
Istovremeno.
The same time, a dynamic life filled with changes and interwoven with challenges stimulates the brain.
Idemo dalje.
Let's move forward. Every day habits that damage your brain and lead to premature aging and deterioration of the brain.
Evo opet da vas upoznam sa jednim neobičnim toksinom.
Let me introduce to you another unusual toxin.
Koji?
Which one?
Pravi probleme.
Creates trouble.
Da li taj toksin se nalazi u vama ili ne? Da li on ulazi u vašu unutrašnjost, ne, to ja ne znam.
Whether the toxin enters your system or not, I don't know.
Ali ja ću vas sedim upoznati.
But I would like to introduce it to you.
Budimo pažljivi.
Let's be careful.
Kako se zove taj toksin?
What's called that toxin? Negative thinking destroys brain cells, leads to a chemical imbalance in the brain and overheating of the body.
Negativne misli I negativni razgovori deluju destruktivno na naš mozak.
So negative thinking and negative communication has distracted effect on the brain.
So da li to vaš problem, ja ne znam.
I do not know whether this is your problem.
Da li imate optimističke ili pesimističke misli.
Whether you have optimistic or pessimistic thoughts.
To prepuštam vama.
I leave to determine.
Da
sam
to da napravite dijagnozu sami sebe.
Yeah, that you find out for yourself where you are.
Sposobnost kontrolisanja svojih misli,
the ability to control the thoughts, your own thoughts,
jedan je od najvažnijih faktora emocionalne inteligencije.
Is one of the most important factors for emotional intelligence.
Prepoznati negativnu misao u trenutku kada se ona javlja.
Identify, recognize the negative thought in the moment it emerges in your brain.
To kontrola misli je, kako kažem, stvar jedne zrelosti, jedne mentalne veštine.
So controlling your own thoughts is a matter of maturity and certain skill.
Jedna izreka kaže.
There is a proverb.
Mi ne možemo zabraniti ptici da prolete preko naše glave.
We cannot prohibit a bird from flying over our head.
Tako isto I negativna misa može se pojaviti u našoj glavi.
So likewise, a negative thought can appear in our brain.
Ali šta mi možemo raditi?
But what we could do.
Zabraniti ptici da napravi gnezdo na našoj glavi.
But we could prohibit the bird from making a nest on our head, right?
Odnosno možemo sprečiti da negativna misa pusti korenje u našoj duši, u našoj svesti.
We can prevent negative thought to put the roots, or let the roots grow in our brain, in our mind.
Zbog čega?
Why?
Zato što je taj fokus pod uticajem naše volje, odnosno frontalnog lobusa.
Because in our frontal lobe we have the control center which can allow or disallow such process.
Šta je fokusiranost?
What is focus?
To je kao ovaj daljinski upravljač.
Our focusing is like a remote control.
Imamo televizor.
We have a screen.
I na televizoru mi imamo ovaj 100 programa.
And you know your TV, you have say 100 channels.
Na jednom kanalu.
On one channel.
Ubijanje, klanje.
And there is a violence, killing.
Nasilje, krv na sve strane.
The blood, it's very, you know, scary.
Na drugom kanalu je nešto.
On another channel.
Isto neka strava i užas.
You are having some horror movie.
Na nekom drugom kanalu nalazi se nešto, neki radosni filmovi,
nešto. And the third channel has something pleasant, something nice or nature.
I mi držimo ovaj remote control.
So you hold in your hand a remote.
I mi odlučujemo koji ćemo kanal gledati.
And you are choosing which channel you want to watch, right?
Isto tako.
Likewise.
Mi odlučujemo.
We control, we make decision.
Koji će se folder u našim memorativnim centrima otvoriti.
Which folder in our memory system will be opened.
Da li folder sa negativnim mislima?
The folder with negative thoughts?
Nekim negativnim sadržajima i događajima?
Content?
Ili ćemo otvoriti folder sa nekom radosnim sadržajem?
Or we will open the folder with some positive, happy thoughts.
Pozitivne misli su ono što treba našem mozgu.
Yeah, so positive and happy thoughts, thoughts are full of hope, stimulating the release of endorphins and oxytocin. Neurotransmitters to help us feel good.
Šta je oksitocin?
What is oksitocin?
Mi smo živjeli, proveli dobar deo života, nismo ni znali da postoji oksitocin.
Greater part of our life we lived without knowing about oksitocin.
Ako bi imali ovdje jednu divlju životinju?
If we would have right now in this room a wild animal.
Ili ako bi ta životinja bila spremna nekog da napadne, da grize.
And if that animal would be ready to attack someone, to bite or...
Ako bi uzeli oksitocin i dali injekciju oksitocina toj životinji...
If we give an injection of oxytocin to that animal...
Šta bi se desilo?
What would happen?
Ta životinja bi postala mirna.
That animal would come down.
I šta? Želju da se mazi...
And desirous to be petted.
Puna nežnosti.
And very gentle.
Oksitocin čini čuda.
So oxytocin does miracles.
Ne samo kod divljih
životinja.
Nego možda čini čuda i u našoj ljudskoj često puta suviše agresivnoj prirodi.
But it can do miracles in our own human, often violent nature.
Sutra govorimo o oksitocinu.
Tomorrow I will talk about oxytocin.
Njegovim efektima.
About its effects.
I kako ga stimulisati.
And how to stimulate it.
I kako taj oksitocin deluje na relation, na odnose naše.
Yeah, and how that oxytocin impacts or affects our relationships, human relationships.
Naš mozak može bolje da radi.
Our brain could work better.
Ali da bi radio bolje moramo više spavati.
But to work better we need to sleep more.
Deficit spavanja deluje nepovoljno na sve mentalne.
So lack of sleep has a negative effect on all mental faculties. So accuracy of human memory decreases by about 25-30% due to lack of sleep if working all night. Sleep helps the brain to consolidate information. Without time to recover during the nighttime sleep, you will not be able to permanently store important data. Those who sleep less have attention disorder, poor concentration, slowed thinking. Sleep is necessary for rejuvenation and recovery or regeneration of the brain.
Ajde vidimo kakav je savjet po pitanju spavanja.
Now let us talk what is the my counsel regarding sleep. Every night we should sleep 8 to 9 hours.
Ne znam koliko ljudi danas spavaju toliko sati.
I do not know whether people sleep today all these hours, I mean so many hours.
Ali 8 sati.
8 hours.
Je potrebno.
It's necessary.
Za naš.
It's a need for our brain. Avoid exercise before bed. Relax before going to bed, shower, bath, stroll, lemon balm tea, relaxing music, prayer.
oni koji spavaju dovoljno,
those who get enough sleep,
imaju 30 i 40% više moždanih hormona u svom mozgu nego oni koji ne spavaju dovoljno.
They obtain or have 30 to 40% more what kind of hormones?
Pre svega melatonina.
These are koji su to hormoni?
Melatonin.
Melatonin. Okay. So they have about 30 to 40% more of melatonin.
Znači, oni koji ne spavaju dovoljno imaju manje.
Yeah, those who do not get enough sleep, they have less of that hormone. Lack of sleep reduces the release of brain hormones, melatonin, brain hormones, that's
Brain, melatonin je hormon dugovečnosti.
So melatonin is the hormone of longevity.
I hormon koji daje mladalačku snagu i energiju.
And the hormone that gives youthful energy.
I našem telu,
to our body,
našoj duši,
to our soul,
i našem mozgu,
our brain.
Što više melatonina ima, duže ćemo i bolje živjeti.
The more melatonin we have, the longer we will live.
Melatonin deluje na naše mentalne procese.
So melatonin improves mental processes, memory, learning, concentration.
Melatonin također deluje na našu psihu.
Melatonin also has antidepressant effect on our psyche.
I nije čudo što danas imamo puno anksioznosti i depresije.
And there is no wonder that we have so much anxiety today, and depression,
Zato što danas većina ljudi pravi grešku po pitanju spavanja.
Because most of people make mistake today with respect to sleep, they don't get enough sleep.
O tome malo kasnije.
About that a little later. Implications of sleeplessness and melatonin deficiency, weakened and impaired immunity, autoimmune diseases and consequences, certainly.
Dokazana je direktna veza između deficita melatonina i karcinoma dojke.
A direct link, so statistically relevant link, has been established between a lack of melatonin and the breast cancer. Okay, so loss of psychophysical strength, exhaustion, sluggishness and fatigue. Decrease in HDL cholesterol, which is a good cholesterol, a rise in LDL or bad cholesterol. Disturbance of secretion of sex hormones, menstrual disorders, reduced concentration of testosterone and reduced spermatogenesis.
Melatonin
se
sintetiše i najviše izlučuje između 12 i 3 sata posle ponoći. Između ponoći i 3 sata posle
ponoći. Is mostly synthesized or released between midnight and 3 in the morning.
Pod uslovom,
under the condition,
da su oči zatvorene,
that the eyes are closed,
i da nikakva veštačka svetlost ne pada na naše oči.
And that no artificial light falls in our eyes.
Ako se to desi,
if that happens,
sinteza i sekrecija melatonina je zaustavljena.
If that happens, that light is coming in our eyes, we don't have a proper sleep, the secretion of melatonin will be suspended or programming.
Hvala Bogu, melatonin se nalazi u određenoj hrani.
Thank God, melatonin is found also in some foods.
Koja hrana nas drži najviše
melatonin? Which foods contain most melatonin?
Oats.
Oats.
I ostale žitarice u celom zrnu.
And other grains, whole grains.
Gde ga još ima?
Where else? So, ginger contains melatonin. So this is a tomato, tomato juice as well. Bananas.
Također sadrže velike koncentracije.
High concentrations of melatonin.
Kada govorimo o spavanju,
when we talk about sleep,
i o melatoninu,
and melatonin,
ja sam rekao da,
I mentioned,
da je potrebno da spavamo 8 sati.
That we need to sleep at least 8 hours.
Ali jako bitno u koje vreme, u koje doba, dana i noći spavamo.
But it's very important what time of the day or night we go to sleep, to bed.
Noću moramo spavati obavezno između ponoći i 3 sata.
So, in the night, it is a must. We must sleep between midnight and 3 o'clock.
Pogotovo deca.
Especially children.
Noću treba da spavamo.
So, during the night we should sleep.
A danju treba da budemo na dnevnoj sunčevoj svetlosti.
And during the day it's desirable to be exposed to the sunlight.
Ja pošaljem 100 pacijenata.
I sent 100 patients.
Samo sa maligno bolešću.
With malignant diseases.
U laboratoriju.
To the laboratory.
Da izmene vitamin D.
To measure to you know the vitamin D.
98% od njih ima deficit vitamina D.
95-98% of the patients that took the lab test have deficiency of vitamin D.
Takođe, 90% osoba sa anksioznošću i depresivnošću,
90% of people who suffer from anxiety and depression,
imaju takođe deficit vitamina D.
Also deficit of vitamin D.
Osobe koje imaju autoimune bolesti, takođe, koje imaju autoimune bolesti, alergije, psorijazu, ekceme, takođe imaju deficit
also
vitamina D.
Also people with autoimmune diseases have like some skin disease and so on, have also a deficiency of vitamin D.
Ako hoćemo da mozak bolje radi,
so if you want the brain to work better,
onda sunčeva svetlost treba da pada na naše lice i na naša ramena.
We need to receive the sunlight.
Sunčeva svetlost i vitamin D stimuliše rad mozga.
So sunlight and vitamin D stimulate the work of the brain.
Centar za memoriju, za kretanje, ne može da radi bez vitamina D.
So the center for motion and orientation and balance cannot work without vitamin D.
I zato je potrebno,
therefore we need,
da svakog dana,
every day,
bar pola sata,
at least half an hour,
budemo na suncu,
to spend at the sunlight.
I da sunčeva svetlost i sunčevi zraci padaju na otkrivene delove tela.
That the sun rays fall on the exposed part of our body.
Svakog dana,
every day,
pola sata,
at least half an hour, spending the sunlight.
Biljka umene ako nema sunčeve svetlosti.
Plant will wither and die if there is no sunlight.
Naš mozak, naš
brain,
naše telo, naše mišići,
muscles,
naš imunni sistem,
immune system,
naš hormonalni sistem,
hormonal system,
umenuće
bez
sunca i
deteriorate without sunlight
i vitamina D
and without vitamin D.
Šta da činimo da naš mozak bolje radi?
What to do for our brain to be better?
Evo ja sam podelio sa vama neke informacije.
I showed you some information.
Važno je dobro da se edukujemo.
It is important to be educated.
I da skupljamo informacije,
gather the information,
koje su bitne za naš život.
The information that is vital for our life.
Hoćemo da budemo srećni.
We want to be happy.
To je prirodna, Bogom dana želja koje utkano u nas.
This is a natural, God-given impulse in our body, in our being.
Hoćemo da budemo uspešniji
život. We want to be more successful in life.
Hoćemo da živimo duže i kvalitetnije.
We want to live longer and have a better quality
imamo
of life.
Imamo probleme u našem životu.
If we have problems in life,
hoćemo da te probleme promenimo, da razrešimo.
We want to resolve the problems.
Mi treba da napravimo reformu u našem životu.
We have to make a reform in our
life. Počnite od reforme svoga mozga.
Please start with the reform of your brain.
Promenite mozak.
Change the condition of the brain.
Kaže Dr. Daniel Amen.
One doctor says, Dr. Amen says.
Koji je uradio 80.000 magnetnih rezonanci.
We did 80,000 magnetic resonance images. Yeah.
Najviše na svetu.
Most in the world.
On kaže, promenite rad vašeg mozga.
Change the work of your brain or operation of your brain
i promenit će vas život.
And your life will be changed.
Promenite rad vašeg mozga.
Change the operation of your brain.
Tako što ćete promeniti vaš životni stil.
So that you, in that way that you change your lifestyle.
I mozak će nam bolje.
And the brain will work better.
Za kraj.
For the end.
Ne zaboravimo.
Don't forget.
Mudar je čovjek jak.
A wise man is strong.
I razuman je čovjek.
Yeah, man of knowledge increases strength.
I kad sa takvim mozgom,
and with such a brain,
sa znanjem i mudrošću,
with the wisdom and knowledge,
mi ćemo znati kako da prođemo kroz ove naše savremene živite.
We will know how to navigate through life.
Da ne oštetimo sebe.
Not to damage ourselves.
Da ne oštetimo druge.
Not to damage others.
Već da, zahvaljujući mudrosti i znanju i razumu,
but through wisdom and knowledge,
budemo sposobni za društvene odnose,
that we may be capable or skillful in human relations,
a ti društveni odnosi,
and these social relations,
u velikoj meri,
in the great degree,
utiču na naše zdravlje,
impact our health,
odnosno na nastanak savremenih bolesti.
or development of modern diseases.
Kako su vezi društva, kako su vezi društveni odnosi i naše zdravlje?
In what relationships stand social relations and our health?
O tome govorimo, o oksitocinu.
About oxytocin.
O tom čudesnom hormonu.
This is a miracle hormone.
Ako Bog da, mi govorimo sutra.
God willing, we will talk tomorrow.
U našem predavanju.
In our lecture.
Hvala na pažnji.
Thank you so much.